Hello everyone, welcome to Mock Bank. Let us start this topic called Profit and Loss. Any aptitude paper is incomplete without having questions from Profit and Loss. So there are certain terminologies that we need to understand before we start solving the problem. So let us try to understand all of them. There are certain terminologies called cost price. So what is the cost price? The cost price, say there is a shopkeeper, and whatever investment is made by the shopkeeper is known to be the cost price, right? And whatever price the shopkeeper demands or wants from the customer and the customer pays is the selling price. So most of the time we should not be confused with selling price, and we must also call it whatever is the billing price. Billing price is the price that customer pays you, is it not? Then we have a profit. Profit is selling price negative cost price. Obviously, for profit to happen, selling price has to be more than that of the cost price. Only then a shopkeeper will make a profit. And what is the loss? Sometimes a shopkeeper may expect to gain a profit, but sometimes it does not happen. So loss becomes is not selling price minus cost price. This is incorrect. This is cost price negative selling price. And for this to happen, cost price has to be more than that of the selling price. Only then one makes a loss. Is it not? Since you have understood all these terminologies, cost price, selling price, profit, loss, let us try to understand what is the marked up price. Marked up price, or we call it to be MP, is the price that a shopkeeper would show to his or her customer, but customer would not be paying this price. Customer would only be paying the selling price, and selling price is billing price. So marked price is a price that customer would see but would not pay. And whatever is the discount that a shopkeeper offers, the discount is offered only on the marked up price. Discount is offered only on the marked up price. Because the customer does not know what is the cost price of the shopkeeper. If customer knows the cost price of the shopkeeper, obviously the customer is going to be in a position to negotiate, and that is the last thing a shopkeeper would want to happen. Hence, the marked up price is the price that a customer would see but would not pay. He would demand a discount on the marked up price. Okay, now another important learning for us is the profit and loss happen on the cost price. So this is the analysis that the profit or loss takes place on cost price and discount is offered on the marked up price. So if we need to find out what is the profit percent, how do we find out profit percent is profit over cost price into 100. If it is a loss, then in denominator it will go as a loss. So that would be loss over cost price, right? So profit percent is profit over cost price, and loss would be loss over cost price. Okay? Now how about finding the discount? Discount is offered on cost on marked price, hence discount is written as the percent of discount. Discount percentage discount over marked up price times 100. Two very important learning for us. Profit and loss percent will be calculated only on cost price, and discount will be offered on the marked up price, and selling price is nothing but the billing price. Right? I hope you're understanding this. So let us try to solve this problem over here. It says that one buys a widget for rupees 100 and sells it, and not sell it, it is like sells it to you for rupees 200. He buys it back from you for rupees 300 and then sells it back to you for rupees 400. So what is the profit that this person is making during the process? So let us talk about inflow of money and outflow of the money. Inflow of the money, and we have got the outflow of the money. Outflow is what he spends, inflow is what he gains. One buys a widget for rupees 100. So there is a outflow of rupees 100 and sells it back. So when once the widget is sold, one will be making 200 rupees, and this is nothing but inflow. Once again he buys it for 300 rupees and sells it for rupees 400. Hence 300 rupees will be the outflow and 400 rupees will be inflow. So total inflow during the process is rupees 600 and total outflow during the process is 400 rupees. So the profit in the process is inflow, whatever comes inside, negative outflow. So this guy actually makes 600 rupees and he spends 400 rupees. So the total profit during the process would be rupees 200. I hope you're getting the logic. I'll see in some other video, or say in the next video, we'll solve some more problems pertaining to profit and loss chapter. Meanwhile, I'll appreciate if you revise your concepts. Bye bye and see you.